Hello students, in this lecture we are going to start a new topic, that is structural representation of organic compounds. Okay, so here there is a small thing, that the organic compounds representation, again it is very very important. Okay, you know the formulas, right? For the methane CH3CH4, for ethane C2H6, for propane C3H8, like that. Okay, but again the representation, okay, there are different representations are there to express the organic compounds. Okay, so that there are different ways to express. The first one is the Lewis dot structure, another one is the complete or dash structure formula, and the third one is the condensed structure formula. Fourth one is the bond line structure formula. So first we can see the Lewis dot structure. Okay, these Lewis dot structures you are already learned in the chemical bonding lesson. Okay, so that I am not going to discuss much detail here. The Lewis dot structure, you know that generally it represents the valence electrons. Okay, so that means suppose you take the ethane, and in this ethane you know that the carbon is arranged around it all the valence electrons. Okay, so like this you can write the Lewis dot structure. And now come to the second one, the complete or dash structure formula. Complete or dash structure formula. Okay, so here the thing is that how you will write that complete dash structure formula is very simple. In the Lewis structure, the Lewis structure can be simplified by representing the two electron covalent bond by a dash. Okay, so that means instead of this two electron pair, you will write a dash. You will write a simple dash. Okay, that represents the bond. That represents the bond here. Okay, so if a single dash is there, it is nothing but the single bond. If there is a double dash, it is nothing but the double bond. If there is a triple dash is there, it is nothing but it represents the triple bond. Okay, and it's the lone pairs of electrons and heteroatoms. Okay, if that molecule contain a heteroatom like oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur or halogen. Okay, so obviously you know that the oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur and halogens contain some lone pairs on it. Okay, so those lone pairs you may be represent or you may not be, you may be show or you may not be show. Meer chupettina chupettakapoyina no problem. Okay, so this is about the complete or dash structure formula. Okay, so here the simple thing is that in the Lewis dot structure, that two electron pair is replaced by a dash. Okay, so very simple. You know that ethane, same example here, the ethane Lewis dot structure, but come to here in the complete dash structure formula, there is a carbon and it is connected with the carbon with the single bond, two electrons, and again with the hydrogen. Okay, so this is about the complete structure formula. Okay, and now come to the ethene. For the ethene, there is a carbon connected with the double bond and connected with the hydrogens with the single bonds. Okay, next one is the ethyne. Look at here, this is connected with a triple bond. Three dashes are there. Okay, so here you have to write everywhere that complete structure. Okay, now come to the methanol with the heteroatom. Okay, so that is CH3OH. You know that what is the formula of the methanol? CH3OH. Okay, that means carbon connected with the three hydrogens with the single bond, and it is with the oxygen, and oxygen connected to the hydrogen, but here there are some lone pair of electrons on the oxygen. So you can represent like this, or else without mentioning that showing the lone pair also, it is okay. Okay, so this is about the complete dash formula. And next one is the condensed structure formula. Okay, so name itself, it is telling that condensed form, it is, that means in the compressed form. Okay, so this can be compressed by omitting some or all of the dashes representing the covalent bonds. Okay, so in that case, jaise manam just now we have mentioned each electron pair with the a dash. Okay, so now what we will do is that in this structure, in the ethane, we will remove all the dashes. We will remove all or some of the dashes. Okay, so suppose take the ethane. Here, what we mentioned in the complete structure formula, we mentioned all the dashes here, but here simply we are writing CH3, CH3. That's it. It is the condensed form. It is a condensed. Next, ethene. In the ethene, you look at here CH2 double bond CH2. Okay, but here the double bond has to be mentioned. The double bond has to be mentioned. Okay, generally we will omit the single bonds. Generally, we will omit the single bonds. Okay, next, you look at here ethyne. Here is the same thing again. We are not showing any single bonds, okay, or dashes. And come to the methanol. You see here, it is again we are writing simply CH3OH. Okay, these are the condensed structural formulas. Condensed structural formulas. Okay, but there is a one more possibility that it can also further compressed by compressed if the number of identical groups are attached to an atom. Okay, suppose you take this example here. Look at here. This is a condensed form already. It is a it's already a condensed form, but again further you can condense this. Okay, how you can condense is that look at here CH3 CH2 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 CH3. Here there are same type of CH2 are there. Okay, here CH2 CH2. Okay, so that means you can further condense by writing the number of CH2 groups in the subscript. In the subscript. Okay, so that means 1 2 3 4 5 6 same kind of 6 CH2 6 CH2s are there. So that here he is mentioning that CH3 CH2 subscript 6 CH3. Okay, this is again further condensed form. Okay, so you will understand very easily. Just you have to practice it. You have to be practice. That's it. Okay, and the next one is the bond line structured representation. Bond line structural representation. Okay, so in this what we will do is that very simple. The carbon and hydrogen atoms are not shown, and we will only represent with the lines. Only represent with the lines. That's it. Okay, and that line representing the carbon-carbon bonds are in the form of zigzag fashion. What is this, sir? Is that very simple? Here we are not going to write the number of carbons and hydrogens or anything. Just we are going to write the lines which represents the carbon-carbon bonds. That's it. Not the carbon-hydrogen bonds. Not the carbon-hydrogen bonds. It is only represent the carbon-carbon bonds, and again we are writing that in a zigzag fashion. Writing in a zigzag fashion. Okay, how we, let us see. So there is a complete structure formula of the ethane is like this, right? Okay, so in this we are omitting all the things carbons and hydrogen. Just we are going to show a carbon-carbon bonds. That's it. With a line, carbon-carbon bond with the line. That's it. So this is nothing but a ethane. Okay. So you have to understand that this terminal carbon is nothing but a CH3, and this terminal carbon is nothing but the CH3. If suppose propane is there, propane, CH3, CH2. CH3. So how we will represent? Again, we will represent the carbon-carbon bonds in a zigzag fashion. In a zigzag fashion. That means this terminal carbon is connected with the CH3, and again this terminal carbon is connected with the CH3, and internal carbon is that here it is a carbon, and based on the valency. You know that four valencies should be there. Okay, already two bonds is over, so that here two hydrogens can be present. Okay, like this in the zigzag fashion we will mentioned. Okay, if suppose CH3 CH double bond CH2 is there, how you will mention is that very simple. We will represent only the carbon carbon bond. This is a single bond and this is a double bond. This is a double bond, that's it. So that means this carbon is a terminal carbon with the CH3, and this carbon is double bond already over, so that it is connected with the two hydrogens. And here again there is a one carbon and 1, 2, 3 bonds already over, so that it has only one hydrogen. So okay, so we have to be careful while writing the number of bonds. The carbon valency is 4. Okay, so you have to be write only 4 bonds around it. You should not write 5 or 6 on, or else 3 or 2. Okay, so you have to write or make it to the valency to the 4, right? Okay, right. And in this representation, again, the only atoms specially written are hetero atoms. Okay, we are not going to write the carbons or hydrogens, but we are going to write the atoms of hetero atoms. Okay, oxygen, chlorine, nitrogen. Okay, any compound, suppose it has oxygen, so you have to write it. If suppose any compound with the chlorine, so you have to write it. Okay, you see example ethane. Here it is a ethane, and here is a propane. It is a propane, and here it is a propanol. Here it is a propanol, CH3, CH2, CH2, OH. Okay, so here the oxygen we are mentioning. Okay, specialty, special, the hetero atoms only we will mention. Okay, so here already I said the terminals denote the methyl group, and while line junctions, what are the line junction? This is the line junction. It denotes the carbon atoms bonded to the appropriate number of hydrogen to satisfy the valency of the carbon. What is the valency of the carbon? It is 4. So that these has to satisfy the valency of 4. Okay, already 2 bonds are there. So that you have to write only 2 hydrogens on this carbon. Okay, like this. And the next one is that there are some examples. 3 methyl octane can be represented in various forms. Okay, so here I am writing the a condensed structure formula. It is here is the condensed one. Okay, 3 methyl octane. Octane means 8 carbons. Here it is a 8 carbon, so that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 carbon. And further there is a one substituent, that is a methyl, at the third position. 1, 2, 3, there is a third position. Don't worry, this nomenclature we are going to see in the next lectures. Okay, so here it is a condensed form, and just for your understanding I am writing here is a complete structure formula. Okay, so carbon connected with the 3 hydrogens, 2 hydrogens, 2 hydro, so there is a carbon connected with the one more carbon. Okay, so this is all about the complete structure formula. Okay, this is the condensed one. And from the condensed to bond line, how you have to convert is that very simple. First you write the carbon carbon bonds. First you write the carbon carbon bond. So this carbon is connected with the CH2, and it is connected with the CH, and this CH is connected with the methyl and connected with the CH2, and this CH2 connected with the one more CH2, CH2, CH2 and CH3. Okay, and after that what you have to do is that you have to remove all these carbons and hydrogens. You remove carbons and hydrogens and you just combine those. Okay, so here combining, so we are removing CH2 and again here and again here, here. Okay, so it is nothing but a bond line formula. It is nothing but a bond line structural representation. Okay, very similar to that. Here is also 2 bromo butane. So here there is CH3 CH Br CH2 CH3. Okay, here is a condensed form again. So I will convert this. First you write the single bonds between the carbon and carbon like this. So carbon and carbon, carbon and carbon, and like this. And then remove all the carbons and hydrogen, just represent the hetero atoms, that's it. okay, it is nothing but the bond line representation. Okay, similarly cyclopropane, so remove the carbons and hydrogens. Cyclopentane, remove the carbon and hydrogens, and chlorocyclohexane. Okay, there is a chloro, so this chlorine you have to represent. Okay, right. And next, there are some problems here. The problem 13.4 in your textbook. Write these condensed formulas to the complete structural formula. Okay, these are the condensed formulas. So you have to write the complete structure formula. Okay, so how you will write the complete structure formula? For one, I am writing CH3. That means there is a three carbons, three hydrogens, and this carbon is connected with the one more carbon, and there are two hydrogens here, and it is connected with the one more carbon, and it is connected with the oxygen with the double bond, and it is connected with the one more carbon with the two hydrogens, and it is connected with the one more carbon with the three hydrogens. Okay, so this is nothing but the complete structure formula. And here you will get a doubt that, sir, the central carbon you are writing the double bond, right? How you come to know that carbon is connected with the oxygen with the double bond? Is that very simple? First, you see that this carbon is connected with the carbon and carbon. Two bonds is over. And any hydrogen on this carbon? No. So that only one oxygen is there. So obviously the carbon valence is the 4. So already two bonds is over. So next two bonds is obviously with the oxygen only. So that it is connected with the double bond. It is connected with the double bond obviously. Okay. And the next, you look at here. Write them in a condensed and bond line formula. So what you have to do? Here it is a some formulas are there. You have to condense again and you have to write the bond line formulas. Okay. So what is the condensed? Here look at here. Here is the one formula is there. Just for A, I am writing the answer. For A, I am writing the condensed forms. So you have to write the bond lines. Okay. So what is the condensed one? So CH2OH and CH2, CH2, CH3, CH, CH3, CH3. Okay. So you have to write the first. So how you have to write first? COH, CH2. Write like this. CH2. CH2. CH in bracket we are writing means it is nothing but a branch, and next is a CH, and again there is a bracket, so that here it is a CH3 and CH3. Okay, so here similarly this CH2 is connected with the OH, but this CH2 and this CH2 is same, right? Okay, so that you condense. Okay, and again don't confuse, these two are same. Okay, here this carbon is connected with the two secondary different carbons. Okay, but here this carbon is connected with the two same CH3 groups. Okay, so that you mention this is a unique, but here it is a two same CH3s are there. Okay, so write them in a bracket, write them in a bracket. Okay, so again I am writing this condensing form, HOCH2CH2 to the power in the subscript 2 and CH CH3 and CH. Okay, this is nothing but a further condensed form of, already here it is in the condensed form, but again this is the condensed form of the above one. Oh, sorry, here he has taken, this is also not the 2, here it is a 3, here it is a 3, here it is 3, and so that here it is 3. Okay, like this. And for this, how you will write this bond line structure with this Very simple. Neglect all the carbon and hydrogens. Okay, so that OH, and you assume it is a carbon CH2 group, and next CH2 is this one. It is over. And next CH2 is this one. This is also over. And next CH is this one. This is also over. And next CH is this one. It is also over. And next methyl is here. So this is also over. Okay, what are left? These two branches. Okay. So here there is a one CH3. This one. And here there is a one CH3 here. Okay. So this is the bond line structure. This is a bond line structure. Okay. So while writing, don't confuse some. So don't write the branches like this. Okay. Don't write like this. Okay. Generally, whenever the end, ee end anedi kindiki unde, adi branch anedi ee kindi vaipe ravali. ఈ ఎండ్ అనేది ఇలా ఉంటే జిగ్జాగ్ ప్యాషన్ లోపల ఇది ఇలానే రావాలి. ఓకే, డోంట్ రైట్ లైక్ దిస్ ఇన్ ఆపోజిట్ డైరెక్షన్. ఇలా రాస్తే రాంగ్. దిస్ ఇస్ ద కరెక్ట్ రిప్రజెంటేషన్. ఓకే, సిమిలర్లీ రైట్ ఫర్ దీస్ ఆల్సో. సో వాట్ ఈస్ దట్ CHOH? హౌ మెనీ సిఎన్ గ్రూప్స్ ఆర్ దేర్? టూ సిఎన్ గ్రూప్స్ ఆర్ దేర్. ఓకే, రైట్ ద సిఎన్ టూ. రైట్ ద సిఎన్ టూ. ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎ కండెన్స్డ్ ఫామ్. ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎ condensed form. Okay, similarly the bond line to complete formula. Here is a bond line is there, you have to write the complete structure. Complete structure. Okay, so first one I will write the structure, complete structure. So each this junction represents the carbon. This junction represents the carbon. Okay, so that a carbon connected with the carbon and again with the carbon and again with the carbon and a carbon and a carbon and carbon. Similarly, this is also connected with a carbon and a carbon and a carbon. That's it. So now satisfy the each carbon valency with the 4 by adding the hydrogens. So two bonds already over, so that hydrogen hydrogen. So two bonds already over, so hydrogen hydrogen, hydrogen hydrogen. Here is also two bonds is over, so that hydrogen and hydrogen. Here carbon 1, 2, 3 bonds are there, so that it contains only one hydrogen. And this carbon again 1, 2, 3 are there, so that it contains only with the one hydrogen. And this carbon, it is connected with the only one, so that it contains 3 more hydrogens. Same thing here is also, it contains 3 more hydrogens. Yeah, it is nothing but the complete formula, complete formula. Very similar to that, you write all the complete formulas for this. Okay, right. Yeah, there is a one important last in this lecture, that is 3D representation of organic molecule. 3D representation of organic molecule. Generally the organic molecule, up to now we are writing on a paper, it is nothing but a 2D picture, and that also you can write in the 3D image. How you will remain write in the 3D image is that by writing the wedge formulas, by writing the wedge a formula. Okay, what is this wedge? Don't worry, we can learn. So here what will happen, generally if suppose you take a methane example, so we will write like this. Okay, that methane we will write like this by using the wedge formula. And in this wedge formula, one is the one of the bond we will mention with the solid bond, and one we will mention with the dash bond. Okay. Okay, so here the important thing is that two hydrogens are a single bond. Generally we'll write with the normal plane, normal lines, and the remaining two bonds we will represent with the one solid thick bond, and one is with the dashed bond. Okay, that is solid as well as the dashed wedge bond. Okay, so here the important thing is that suppose you are writing on the paper, so on the carbon, here it is a carbon, here you are writing the carbon, and there is a hydrogen, and here it is a hydrogen, two hydrogen. So you have to assume that on the paper there is a carbon and two hydrogens are there on this paper. Okay, and what about the remaining two hydrogens? The remaining two hydrogens are here, these are on the paper, and remaining two hydrogens are there perpendicular to the paper, perpendicular to the paper. Okay, so that means in the perpendicular of the paper, that should be one is away to you, and one should be, if one is away and one should be close to you. Okay, so that means these two are on the paper, and remaining two are the perpendicular to this paper. Perpendicular to this paper. Okay, so that means in that again one is close to you and one is away to you. Okay, so ee away tho edaithe undo danni manam dash tho chupettam, edaithe manaki close ga untundo danni manam we will represent with a thick wedge formula. Okay, so this is nothing but the 3D representation. 3D representations. Okay, so that's all about this 3D representation of organic molecules.